The day after the referendum, we've learned that the ECB is going to once again reconvene the governing council to discuss what to do about the emergency liquidity assistance to Greece. That's a really wonky way to say whether or not the country gets more cash so that you can get more money out of the ATMs. They're clearly going to be looking to see the outcome of that referendum to make any decisions about what's going to happen next. But just because there's a yes vote doesn't necessarily mean we start to see the banks reopen next week. There's a lot of political things that have to happen first before that. In the meantime, the country is in full campaign mode. Posters are going up throughout the city. If you want to learn some Greek this morning, the no posters say OXI. It's not pronounced oxy, it's pronounced ohi. That is Greek for no. And then there's also the yes posters that are going up. Yes in Greek is ne, N-A-I, and you see those in a lot of the bus stations as well. Plus, there are campaign ads for both sides on television throughout the day, and we're also seeing it on Facebook and Twitter feeds as well. One other note, if you're trying to send money to somebody in Greece via Western Union or MoneyGram, not going to work. They're basically shut down. You can actually go to a kiosk and exchange money if you have dollars at this point, if you're a foreigner. But right now, if you've got, you know, a college student here who's vacationing or backpacking through here, you can't get money to them and you can't get it out either. Back to you guys.
Michelle, I just want to point out the significance of what you're clearly making out there, that the European Central Bank will discuss the emergency funding to Greece on Monday. The Dutch finance minister said today that if there was a no vote, the Eurozone could no longer support Greece. So there is an implicit threat in what you're saying there, that actually the European Central Bank won't increase the amount of liquidity. It could actually cut liquidity to the Greek banks and therefore essentially bring them down. That's the implied threat in what you're saying there, I believe.
Oh, yeah, that's absolutely true. There's a whole legal process that the ECB goes through, which is, you know, way too wonky to put on television. But the implication of what you're saying is absolutely true, Simon. The outcome, if there's a no vote here on Sunday, the banks are going to struggle even more dramatically than they are already this week. If there's a yes vote, then there's some room for movement. That doesn't mean the banks open Monday, Tuesday, maybe even not at all next week, because there's got to be some political movement as well by whoever's in charge. But yeah, it could be very bad.